When it comes to Lil Nas X, he's gone from someone who was able to be famous for one song to being infamous for expressing who he is in a variety of ways that has gotten people a bit rocked. Think about what Dennis Rodman did in the 90s during his own coming out phase in terms of him showing his personality in a way that people didn't expect. Now apply that to a 22-year-old rapper and you've got Lil Nas X. To prove that, he went and took a major controversy that happened earlier this year and turned it into fodder for his next song. We'll break it down for you. Let's get right into it. There's been a lot of talk that has been going around recently in regards to what is and what isn't happening with Lil Nas X. And to put it quite simply, all of this stems from a shoe incident that Lil Nas X did and got a lot of heat for. Early in the year, Lil Nas X launched a controversial pair of Satan shoes featuring a bronze pentagram, an introverted cross, and a drop of real human blood. Yeah, he really did that. It was so popular that it sold out in minutes. It wasn't just a random thing that happened though. It was Lil Nas X and Mischief, a New York-based art collective, who did this. The shoes were made using Nike Air Max 9s, though the sportswear brand was not pleased with what was going on without their knowledge. In an emailed statement, Nike said it was not involved in creating the modified sneaker. We do not have a relationship with Lil Nas X or Mischief. Nike did not design or release these shoes, and we do not enforce them. Mischief confirmed that the limited edition of 666 pairs sold out in less than a minute. The Lil Nas X kept the first pair. Each shoe's air bubble sole contained red ink and one drop of human blood, according to Mischief. A Mischief spokesperson said the blood had been provided by members of the art collective, adding, "We love to sacrifice for our art." Later, Wisner explained on a video call that the creative team collected individual drops over the course of a week, using the same type of needle used in an at-home glucose test. The group also confirmed to CNN that Nike was not involved in this in any capacity. Needless to say, this was something that felt very much like Lil Nas X, just as easily to say a lot of people were not happy that this happened for various reasons, both fair and not. The reactions to the shoes. The shoes sparked a massive outrage online once they were announced. It attracted criticism from a number of high-profile political and religious figures, including South Dakota Governor Kristi Noem and evangelical pastor Mark Burns. The latter described the sneakers in a tweet as evil, and some fans of the Old Town Road rapper meanwhile Twitter their support and desire to own a pair. In response, Lil Nas X posted a video to his official YouTube account titled "Lil Nas X Apologizes for Satan Shoe," which got millions of views. After a few seconds, the apparent apology cuts to a scene from his new music video, Montero Call Me By Your Name, showing him provocatively dancing with a devil character. The rapper is then pictured snapping the devil's neck before removing his horn crown and assuming it himself. The day after Lil Nas X released the music video, he responded to the backlash over its rebellious religious imagery with, "I spent my entire teenage years hating myself. So I hope you are mad, stay mad, feel the same anger you teach us to have towards ourselves." Wisner stated, "We all knew that some people would take the Satan element of this thing seriously, but I'm not sure if we will entirely be prepared for how much of a fur it would raise. Obviously, from our perspective, it's just fun, right? There's a really rich wealth of symbolism to work with, but some people have been very up in arms with it." He referenced one YouTuber reviewer, Michael J. Mitchell, of the account A Sneaker Life, who first did an unboxing video, then posted a follow-up video called "I Threw the Nike Satan Shoes Away." According to Wisner, he threw the shoes away due to his fan base reacting so poorly to his video, which is extremely funny. In the 8-minute video, Mitchell announces his getting rid of the sneakers before tossing them down the trash chute in his apartment building. He shows them in the box before they make their descent. Mitchell then goes on to say that he was throwing them away. He didn't want the toxic energy sticking around his channel. He told everyone to just relax, that he was a man of God. Overreactions all around, but in their own way, yes. But there is more going on here than just the religious outrage. For some, this was more of a business look. The business most upset was Nike, who didn't waste time trying to make sure everyone knew that they weren't happy about this at all. Nike accused Mischief of trademark infringement after it appeared to use the Air Max 97 shoe for inspiration for its Satan shoe. Nike also said customers had called for a boycott of the company over Mischief's shoe. The basketball player Nick Young tweeted he debated wearing Nike after the announcement of the Satan shoes. Nike follows the lawsuit to maintain control of its brand to protect its intellectual property and to clear the confusion and delusion in the marketplace by setting the record straight. Nike has not and does not approve of or authorize Miss Chief's customized Satan shoes, the suit said. Now you might think this is a cheap ploy to go and get something for Miss Chief, but that wasn't the case. They really wanted to sue them, and in April, they reached a settlement on the matter. On April 8th, Nike and Miss Chief agreed to settle the lawsuit. Nike said if any purchasers were confused or if they otherwise want to return these shoes, they may do so for a full refund. This obviously caused its own stir because it was all about Lil Nas X. He made a special pair of shoes and technically speaking, he's taken to court over it. So he made a music video about it. On July 19th, the rapper shared a video titled Nike vs. Lil Nas X Satan Shoes Trial, in which the rapper performed a full 2-minute sketch acting out his own fictional legal battle against the iconic shoe brand for his viral Satan shoes, acting in the sketch as himself, his lawyer, opposing counsel, the judge, and more. Lil Nas X, the fictitious court trial which quickly devolves from being about his shoes to focusing on his sexuality. Let me rephrase the question. His lawyer character was pictured asking him while on the stand in the video. While he answers yes, a juror also played by Lil Nas X makes his feelings on the matter clear, saying, "Lock him up, throw away the key." The clip ended with Lil Nas X being sentenced to 5 years in prison, referring to his number one single, Montero Call Me By Your Name. A teaser appeared on the screen of his new single, Industry Baby, which is out now, which he knows the controversy that has come by his shoes and his last song. He decided to go and do a warning about the one coming up, saying this in advance so none of his fans will blame him, claiming his video is not for their kids. While Lil Nas X is a very weird character as of late, the fact of the matter is he's a very aware individual who is more than willing to be what he is, even if the world doesn't hear it. He knew that his own road was not the easiest to travel, and so on. Twitter, he decided to go and pen a letter to himself, addressing it to his younger self from a few years back. "I wrote a song for us." The start of the letter, Lil Nas X wrote that he was feeling stuck in a place when the global shutdown started in early 2020, both literally and figuratively. He wrote, "I know sometimes you feel like it's all downhill from here. I know going from having the biggest song in the world to being trapped in your apartment is weighing heavy on you. I know if you hear the phrase, one hit wonder one more time, you might combust." As the note continued, Lil Nas urged his younger self to be strong and to get through to the other side, only so he can witness his own success. "But I need you to keep going. I need you to realize that you have the opportunity that you need to grow up. I need you to stop feeling sorry for yourself, and I need you to remember that the only person who has to believe in you is you," he wrote. He's done this before, the last time being addressing how he came out to the world and encouraging himself to not forget that what his self-worth was. So while many factions in the world may not like all the things he's done, the fact is that he's a young man trying to be himself 100% without fear. That's something to be respected. By the time you're watching this video, his new video and song will have been released. It's aiming to be something very unique, in a Lil Nas X kind of way, of course. The gassed up new anthem produced by Tate, A Day Trip, and Kanye West sees Lil Nas X and featured guest Jack Harlow at its most triumphant kickoff with the horn fanfare. As though announcing its own arrival, Industry Baby sees the 22-year-old rapper with his accolades over driving a beat and sick melody. Baby bet, a couple racks, a couple Grammys on him, and a couple plaques. He smirks in the opening lines of the song before ultimately declaring that this one is for the champions. If you look at the video, you'll see he's doing yet another outlandishly thing on his video, including him dancing with several naked men, which will no doubt send certain groups up the wall once again. Given who Lil Nas X, you could bet that he is just someone who doesn't care, because this is his life and his truth, and he's going to showcase who he is no matter what. Before the song aired, he issued SpongeBob SquarePants to try and promote the now released track. Other than that, thank you guys for watching today's video. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like and comment, "Rip Lil Nas X."